How are you all? Alhamdulillah. Sorry. So for my starters, I just wanted to tell you just a small story. A couple years ago, I was sitting in my first ever physics class. I was talking with my friends, and the teacher was going on about the basics of physics. So Newton's laws of motion, acceleration, velocity, all the basic things you take in any physics class. And don't get me wrong, I was very interested in what the teacher was going on about. What the teacher was teaching was isolated to what was shown in the classroom and what was written on the board. And while that's not a problem, it definitely isolated what I knew. A couple months go by, and my dad sits me down to watch a movie. Have any of you watched Interstellar before? Amazing movie, one of my favorites ever. And that movie had introduced me to a whole new world of physics, astrophysics specifically. And so I couldn't get my eyes off of what they were talking about, what they were explaining. While I didn't know what was being said at first, it definitely completely piqued my interest. So, start to finish, my eyes had not left the screen. And the moment that movie ended, I knew I had to teach myself more. I opened my laptop directly after, and I entered a whole new world of physics that I would have never imagined. Astrophysics, quantum physics, and I went deeper into Einstein's theory of general relativity. And so, at some point in that intensive research, I had stumbled upon the theory of everything. Has anyone heard of the theory of everything before? Okay, so before I'm able to get into the details of what the theory of everything is, it's important that we all develop an understanding of where we are now. Right now, we have two separate theories. We have quantum physics, and we have the Einstein's theory of general relativity. Two very different theories. While Einstein's theory of general relativity focuses on, it's essentially the theory of gravity, and it has helped us discover and understand the black holes of our universe, the behavior of it, and gravitational forces. While on the other hand, we have quantum physics, which is basically the study of energy and matter down to the most subatomic particles, or the fundamental levels of it. And it's helped us discover and create MRIs and lasers and, of course, quantum computing and electronics. But as you can see, these two theories are very different. They're very contradicting for each other. And I know this right now is just the introduction to it. It may not be of any interest, but it's going to help us understand what I'm going to talk about next. Right now, that's just the basic. We have a current challenge. Right now, the challenge is that quantum physics and general relativity, they're not interchangeable. While the laws of quantum physics, they're not applicable to general relativity and vice versa. They're irreconcilable. And so, what exactly are scientists trying to do about it? Anyone have any idea of what scientists are trying to do? Anyone? And basically, what scientists are trying to do is they're trying to find a way to unify these two separate theories into one all-encompassing set of laws that'll help and allow us to apply them to everything. So I've explained a good chunk of it. Hopefully, everything I've explained so far should start to make sense to as many of you that can understand it. But this brings us to the main question is, what is the theory of everything? So what's the theory of everything? Is there a theory of everything? This is where I ask the question. So, do you know what the theory of everything is, or if there is one? We don't have one. There is no theory of everything. It's an idea, it's abstract. I haven't discovered it. I do plan on doing so, though, but the scientists, they also haven't. But what I can do is I can explain what the point of the theory of everything is. The point of it is that scientists, as I previously mentioned, is that they're supposed to unify two theories into one coherent whole. What's the point of it? What's the point of having an explanation for everything in one set of laws? What's the point of having that? What's going to come out of it? Is anything going to come out of the theory of everything? Maybe there is, maybe there isn't. We don't know. We don't know what's going to come out of it. But given that we don't know what's going to come out of it, we know that it's going to be impactful. It's going to explain something in our world. But there's nothing we know at the moment. But what can happen next is what we can do is we can continue and move it on to the next generation. So now that we know that there isn't really a theory for everything in our world, we do know that there's a step in a direction. And so,
Curiosity is how we move forward. Curiosity is needed to move forward in the future. We're humans, we're naturally curious, we have to be curious. It's how we discover half of the, all of the things that we know today were through our curiosity. And so take my 10-year-old sisters, for example. Those two girls, I think the only thing they know how to do is ask questions. Whether it's basic or observed or obvious, they're willing to ask that question regardless of what it is or what it's about. And to some, this may not seem like anything. It's any curious child asking a question. But in reality, it shows that the future generations, they are going to continue our studies and questions. It gives us hope for the next generation. It shows that something will come out of it. And so,
because we were given the privilege and advantage of learning about these, something that we've never heard, the older generations haven't heard before, we get to learn it into a whole other level. And so what I hope, continue with our questions and maybe develop the answers in their generation. We have no idea what the theory of everything could do. We do know that it has the potential to be more groundbreaking than Einstein's theory of general relativity. It could create an impact in our learning and our education, how we understand and teach things. Just because we don't know what it is doesn't mean we don't know the impact it can have on us. And so the reality is, we may never know. We may never end up with an answer, maybe in our generation or the next, maybe for the next century. But it's the curiosity that drives our existence. It's what allows us to find new things and continue with our lives. And so you really don't need a PhD to wonder and ask. I'm no physicist, I don't have a PhD, but I'm still standing here and continuing with my questions and my research without what may be considered eligible. Because that's just the way it is. You don't need a PhD to wonder about the universe. If anything, it's the questions we ask and the answers that we seek. That's what shapes the discoveries beyond tomorrow. And so, without curiosity, there's nothing we can move on with. There's no step in the right direction. We'll just be moving backwards if we stop asking questions. So when it comes to all of this, what is important is that it was curious individuals that helped achieve all of these scientific achievements. It's what we're supposed to do. It's what we exist to do. And so all scientific achievements and milestones, they were made by people who asked the big questions, who continued to look for their own answers and ask what they wanted to do. And if anything, I hope to become one of them. And that's my goal, is to become a person that's willing to ask the questions and find the discoveries and create those achievements. And I hope that we all strive to do the same. Thank you for your time.